Hey, Oakwood friends, it is wonderful to see you. The question I got most of the build-up to remote learning was, how are we going to do PE remotely? Well, in many different ways, and it'll look differently because we have different spaces for each of us of what we can do. But we have options, and we, even though it's going to be different, although we're going to have to be creative, we are going to make it work, we're going to make it work well, and we're going to be active and healthy, and it is going to be good. So stick with me. But before we get started, you need to discuss with your remote learning supervisor. Now, that might be somebody that's taking care of you just for during the day. That could be your parents, but whoever is in charge of you right now. Not me. Yes, I'm leading your PE instruction, but there's somebody physically at the place with you that's in charge of you. And you need to go ask them as soon as I'm done with this little video, and then you'll come back to the PE form here. You need to ask them where you can do PE class during remote learning. Some of you can go outside. Some of you can clear out an area and play in the garage. Some of you can go in the basement. Some of you have an area upstairs in the house that you can go, or a bedroom. Others might have a very small area that's your area for remote learning, and you have to stay there. So right now, I want you to go and ask who's ever in charge of you, your remote learning supervisor, your parent, your grandparent, your guardian, whoever it may be, ask them, where can I do PE class, and does it look for me to do it there safely? We don't want to create any more work for anybody in it because of remote PE. We want this to be something that's safe, something that keeps the area safe, but something that gets you moving, gets you learning, and excites you towards physical education. All right, go ask, come back. We've got more questions, more videos, and more learning to do today.